What is up, everyone, and welcome back to the Tax Sell Starters, where we teach you the best tips on tax sell investing. In today's video, I'm going to teach you the top three tax lien investment strategies to help you create your own investment strategy so you can increase your investment opportunities, increase your ROI, and increase your overall success. So if you're just getting started, or if you've been investing in tax liens and deeds but want to learn how to get the most out of your investment in time, then let's just jump right in. Now, before I tell you my tip, there's one thing you need to know. Time is king. I say this at the beginning of every video. And what I mean by this is, if you want to succeed in tax sell investing, you need to make sure that you can sift through and research a large number of properties quickly in order to find your ideal investments. Because picking the wrong properties increases your risk. And if you're dealing with liens or redeemable deed, time plays a huge role in how long your investment can be sitting in a property before you can actually take possession or expect to make a return on your investment. At the end of the day, all you should care about is generating a return on your investment that will grow your money. That's why in today's video, one tip that I'm going to share with you is really going to help you maximize your return without wasting time. That said, let's just dive right into the tip of the day. And that tip is, before you begin investing, understand the top three tax lien investment strategies. Okay, so typically, property owners have a specific amount of time to pay their property taxes before they become delinquent. At the end of that time, the county, the tax collector to county treasury, issues a tax lien for the unpaid tax amount. The tax lien acts as that security for the lien against the property until the taxes are actually paid or the lien is sold. Before buying a tax lien, you want to make sure that you have a strategy that best fits your goal and your finances. Now, each state has its own statutes, so you want to make sure that you read and understand those statutes because the difference in the rules can and will impact your strategy. Check out the video, Tax Liens or Tax Deeds, How to Select the Right Investment for You. In that video, I cover the different instruments. I'll go ahead and post that video somewhere on the screen and at the end of this video. Okay, if your goal is to generate money from interest income, select states that pay high interest rates. There are different states that do that. If you don't know which states, check out taxsellfinders.com, where you can easily do this research and find these answers. If you want to own the property or at least have a greater chance to foreclose on a property and take possession, then look for states that have a short redemption period or absolutely no redemption period at all. Let's get into the top three tax investment strategies. The first strategy is called buy and hold strategy. This strategy works well with states that have high interest on their tax liens. Basically, you're buying a tax lien and you're holding it for a long period of time to generate the most interest on that property. The second strategy is called the assignment strategy. Now, this strategy is for investors who want to profit from tax liens but don't want to keep their money inside of investment for a long period. This strategy can be used in counties that allow you to assign a lien to someone else. So you actually buy the lien and then sell it to someone else before it's redeemed. This is called the secondary market, and tax liens can be sold through online auctions just by registering and listing your tax lien there. So how it works is, after the auction, you go to the county tax collections website, download the documents to show the lien ownership was transferred to the winning bidder, which is you. Now that you have your documents, you can present these documents when selling them into the secondary market. Okay, that's assignment strategy from a general view. As with any strategy, do your homework. I'm just giving you a high-level view. I don't propose to give you a strategy or suggest the best one for you. It's your money and no one should tell you how to invest it. So as you're formulating a strategy and thinking about what to do, how much capital you have, the various options, you also want to think about one more strategy. The third and final strategy is called the foreclosure strategy. The foreclosure strategy is about buying liens with very short redemption periods or no redemption period at all. The goal is that the homeowners don't redeem. Once the redemption period expires, you foreclose on the homeowner's right to redeem that lien, and then it gets converted into a tax deed. For example, you must wait 3 years after purchasing a tax lien in Arizona before you can begin the foreclosure proceedings. However, in Florida, you can start the foreclosure as soon as you purchase the tax lien. Keep in mind, the lien foreclosing process is actually foreclosing on the lien. In some states, when you foreclose, you don't automatically obtain a deed, while in other states, you do obtain a deed by simply foreclosing on a tax lien. Today, we briefly reviewed the top three tax lien investment strategies. The buy and hold strategy, when you buy a high interest lien and hold it for a period of time. We covered the assignment strategy, where you buy the lien and then you sell it off to the secondary market to someone else who's interested in purchasing that lien. Again, not every state allows you to do that. Make sure you know what counties allow assignments. And lastly, we talked about the foreclosure strategy, a popular strategy when you're really after the property. So you want to get to a state that has a short redemption period. When the lien expires, then you can go foreclose on a homeowner's right to redeem the lien back. And then you can go after the deed. Remember, some counties will automatically hand you the deed or convert it to a deed after the lien period expires, while other counties will require a secondary process where they conduct a tax deed auction. In those states, you won't get the deed without bidding again, and in that case, you have to be the highest bidder or whatever the process is. So remember, as you begin building or refining your investment strategy, consider the top three strategies and how they may fit or inspire creativity in your own strategy. Don't forget to check out taxsellfinders.com, where you get all the latest auction lists, research liens, deeds, perform due diligence, and much, much more, so you can grow your investment like a pro. If you love this tip that I gave you on the top three investment strategies, then make sure you hit the notification bell so you can keep up with our latest videos, providing you with the tips and insights every week. I hope you have a great day, happy investing, and I'll see you on the next one.